me.
Can I ask a question? Do y'all feel as if a lot of women are single because of their friend group?
And so you answer that, and then I want the
Absolutely.
Queen Saria to answer it as well.
This is also so related. A lot of time in friend groups, especially with women, there's a lot of jealousy. And these are things that I've seen. There is. Don't be that one that everybody thinks is the pretty one or the Beyonce or this. Like, there's a lot of jealousy. And sometimes you'll get, bad advice. Especially let you be the one that's in a relationship and everybody else single. Yeah, and if that person that's in a relationship is not aware enough of the facts and is listening to their single friends that he sh where she doesn't realize that they're actually jealous of her, yeah, they're gonna ruin that relationship. And that plays a huge that's a huge factor in why some of us are single.
Queen Zaria, what do you have to? What's your answer to that question?
Aria, oh my
God,
God,
bro,
this is gonna
we've
go
been
on
over this, bro.
forever.
It's Zaria, right?
Yes, it's Zaria.
That's
We
the
literally tell
last
him
time
to
I'm
call
saying it
me
wrong.
Z, and he still doesn't do it like every
That's the
time.
last time I'm gonna say it wrong. I promise. Watch.
He said that last line.
What was the question? Like, there's two different topics going on. What
Ask
was the
her the
question?
question again, Issy.
Do you feel like a lot of times the reason that women are single is because of their friend group?
I can kind of agree with that. I think that girls also make more space for their men and neglect their friend groups, which in turn, like So-So said, has like that jealousy factor. Like men can balance having a girlfriend and still being able to like hang out with their friends and like go have guy time. But like girls kind of like get obsessed with like their man, and then it becomes like you neglect your friends and you don't hang out with them or you don't whatever, and it's like it's weird. Then they break up with the guy and they like come back to the friend group like nothing happened. I think that's where girls get real like back and forth with the boyfriends, and the friend groups kind of do ruin that because they don't know how to balance. But as far as like the friends hyping them up to do wrong stuff, as much as we hate to believe it, sometimes our friend groups are like a reflection of us. So like if they got friends who are like if they got friends who are like, oh girl, you need to dump him, like blah blah blah, the friend is probably single. So I mean, do you take relationship advice from a single friend, or do you take accountability for like what you want to do? Like there's girls who stay with men who cheat, but their friends convinced them to break up with them. Like if that's what you want to do, stay with that man. Like who cares?
All
I
right. The
guess
only thing I would say to that is I wouldn't even call it being obsessed with your man, because when you get in a relationship, that's more time you got to invest in that. You got to invest more time in that as you're getting to know that person, just spending time to, like that's your significant other now. So of course you're not going to be hanging out with your friends as much as you used to. It's not obsession, it's just being in a relationship. And if your friends don't understand that and they don't respect that, they don't respect your relationship, they don't respect you, they don't respect the man, like no, that's not a friend. That's not a friend at all.
The only reason I use the word obsession is because boys have a better balance. Like boys like can still hop on a game or like go out with their boys and like come back and like do date nights. Well, some boys, the boys I've dated, like they have a better balance versus like girls like want to be either together all the time or like with their man all the time. Like remember the topic that was just like maybe a month or two ago where they were like, if my man calls and we're out, I'm leaving my friend group, like blah 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 blah. You know what I mean? And like that's not a bad thing, but like you still gotta communicate with your friends, like, hey, before we all go out, I may have so and so pick me up versus like just disappearing. Like that I think was the main problem. It's like men know how to balance, like, and there are some girls that'll call their man on a day out, like, you need to be home. But like it goes back and forth. But I think they have better balance, so they still maintain those friendships. Like guys would be like, oh yeah, he do got a girl now. Like we know we can't invite him to do this, and that. Girls, we don't have that. Like we still invite our single friends, married friends, engaged friends, all to the same stuff every time.
So Z, what are your thoughts on what she said in that video?
I didn't even like watch or tune into like the whole thing, but I will say
all three of y'all mute up. We got new people in here anyway. I'm gonna play the video one more time. All three of y'all, please mute up. I'm gonna play the video one more time. Ladies, don't be afraid to come up here and speak. I mean, play the video one more time.
Ladies, can we start a thread? Because I want to talk about something that I haven't heard. And I just want to know if anyone else, any women are experiencing this. Quick backstory. Coming up, I always had low self-esteem. I never felt attractive. I didn't really have friends. I was pretty much a loner. And so as an adult, I still have some of those thoughts in my mind. And it could honestly affect how I present myself when I'm out. But with that said, I have a lot of gorgeous friends, okay? Everybody's pretty. Everybody's pretty. Can we talk about how we are not the woman that's like ever approached in the friend group? More specifically, how you internalize it, how you deal with it. You know, because it's hard for me to believe that I'm the pretty girl when I'm out and men don't approach me. I tell you guys all the time that, like, I get the most attention from guys on the internet, not out in public. I for the most part, I'm never approached, just to keep it a buck. Or I'm approached by super older guys, like 50 and up. Nobody in my age range. And I don't care how many times my friends tell me I'm pretty. People at church tell me I'm pretty. When it's all said and done and I'm in a room with them, I'm never seen. And it's kind of hard to deal with. And then you can't even really talk to your homegirls about it, because if you tell them, then they're going to be self-conscious about how they are in your presence, and you don't want to dim their light because you love them. But, like, what do I have to do? Distance myself from pretty people? Like, that doesn't make sense. I don't know. How do y'all deal with it? Do you talk to your homegirls? Do you just internalize it? Do you talk to other people? Do you just ignore the feelings? Like, because that's my thing. When I'm by myself and I meditate or I look at myself in the mirror, I feel beautiful. And then I get around other pretty girls and I feel like the ugly duckling. And nobody can convince me that I'm attractive. That's why it's hard for me to receive compliments. That's why it's hard for me to trust that what people are saying they mean. Because my life experience tells me otherwise. Otherwise, so how do you deal with it if you are dealing with it, ladies?
Z, what are your thoughts on that, Queen? Have you been that woman in the friend group that when y'all went out, you weren't getting any attention from the men? If so, how did you go about dealing with it? And if not, have you ever been conscious or aware of? Have you ever been in a situation, whether it was one time or even consistently, where one of your friends at whatever time of your life when y'all went out, she wasn't getting any attention from men?
Okay. A couple things. So I cannot say I have been that friend, so I can't like speak from that girl's experience. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I have been out with friends and like they'll go to my friend, you know, like guys will come up to me or they'll go up to her, like, cool. That's not a problem. Me and my friend always have a rule though, that like when a guy does approach our friend group, he needs to like address everybody. I think they feel like the ugly duckling because a guy will come up and try to like pull the friend away. Like you can be kind and still be like, hey, how y'all doing? And then pursue the person you're trying to pursue, you know, like it's a respect factor, not necessarily like everybody move out the way. I'm just trying to talk to her. Like that's rude. Like, you know what I mean? And then the second thing is I came in when you were reading a comment where someone was like, you just need to get more friends, that you feel prettier than. Mm-hmm. Absolutely not. Cause that's like, it's the lowest of the low you can go to try to find friends that you feel cuter than because you want attention in public. She has to do like her own self-worth work, you know, to figure out where she
Hold on, Sharma, please mute up. I'll talk to you next. I'll talk to one person at a time. Go ahead, Z.
Yeah, but like I think she just came on the internet like looking for advice, and I feel like that's what these forums are for. Like, even though she kind of getting attacked and on all these shade rooms and stuff, it probably don't make her feel any better. But like, somebody just gotta talk to her about like you gotta be able to look in the mirror and feel that you're right. And then my last point was, appearance wise, you can be pretty, but how you put it together can be real like frumpy. Like, I don't know, have you all ever seen somebody that's attractive, but like maybe they just started their makeup journey, so it's a little off? Or maybe they walk in a room and have like no confidence, and their shoulders are slouched and they looking down at the floor. Like, it could be a confidence thing too, and like how you put it together. Like, I've seen super pretty girls with super pretty figures, but they walk in the room and like maybe the clothes are half hanging off, or maybe too tight, or whatever the case is, that can play a big part in like getting the attention that you want. And then like maybe she's not walking in the right rooms. Like, maybe these not the type of people that you want to be surrounded around, because they looking for Instagram models and they kind of vain, you know? So she just needs to look in the right places and kind of like look in the mirror and do a little self-worth work.
Do you so you before I go on to vape, so Z, you said you talked about how her, if she was to attempt to try to make friends with people that, I don't know, in her head or society would see her, deem her to be generally more physically attractive than, you said that'd be the lowest of the low. Do you think that there are a good amount of women that actually practice that behavior though, honestly?
I don't personally know any girls that surround themselves around girls that they feel prettier than, but in friend groups, I know that that's a thing to like want to feel like the top dog or like the Regina George of the group. But like, I know, like, I have a lot of guy friends, and they will walk past your whole friend group. Like, trying to be the prettiest one out of girls does not make you prettier to the guys that you're trying to get. That doesn't work. It's backwards work, because next thing you know, like, instead of that one or two friends is getting attention, now nobody in your friend group is getting attention. Now nobody is like getting in the club. Nobody's getting that. So it's like, that's only gonna make it worse.
I'm one more thing. So at the end of the day, like, ladies, let me tell y'all something, okay? Because I keep it real. So the same way, like, y'all want the man that's the most accomplished, y'all want the most successful man out the group, like, y'all want the man with the most money. When it comes to you and your friends, men are gonna want the one that they deem to be the most attractive. And like, let's be real, ladies. When y'all go out, y'all, all of y'all can get in before 11, 11:30, whatever the promoter is doing that night. But y'all getting in for free, and y'all are in general admission. All of y'all are not going to get the opportunity to be in VIP. Not all the men that are in VIP, if they like Z, they're gonna tell Z to come in VIP with them. They're not gonna tell Z and her friends to come with. So we're not all equal at the end of the day. And you need to charge it to the game if you find yourself in situations like this constantly. And we talk all we do all this talk about safety and women protecting themselves. Like the comment that I read, and I've been saying this, I think y'all need to go out more by yourself. For whatever reason, y'all be thinking that, like, to be honest with y'all, most men really don't want to approach a woman when
A
they see
group.
her amongst other women.
Exactly.
It greatly reduces the chances of being approached. But I don't know, y'all don't want to go out by yourself. But that's just my little two cents. So you wanted to say something?
Yeah, there was a comment about how, she was asking for advice, and correct me if I'm wrong, but I did not hear her asking for advice. She sounded like she wanted to talk to other people who have experienced the same thing. I'm trying to find a comment. There was an answer. I think that was basically, I can't remember what else the person said, but it's not about advice. This person is obviously does not think that it's internal. She just thinks that it's outside factors. She thinks that it's the men. What she didn't say, what's wrong with me, or like, why this, or like, can you guys give me some advice? Can you guys tell me what I can do differently? She didn't, if that's how she was coming, she would have asked her friends, like, what are you guys doing that I'm not doing?
Okay, but I'm gonna be honest. Like, okay, so first of all, noble.
We die.
We died. This is another We Died reunion. We died.
Hey, sis, listen. Listen, I'm a married, to, listen, way, I'm a married man. I'm a married man going on 4 weeks.
I know. You, can you stop? Do you know what it was? Loving married
life, loving being a husband. Can you stop? And I'm okay, so noble, happy. Listen, we died. I'm so happy that I don't have to like deal with, you know, these. I'm not going on right now, but I'm happy that I don't have to deal with a lot of these women anymore. But
bro, like noble, you know what I wanted to do for you? I wanted to do like that little African.
Oh my god.
You already know.
Like, wait a minute.
Congratulations.
Wait, we died. Did you hear the audio though?
Wait, the audio of what?
The audio of the
green. Because you know, screen. I'm like this. I am toxic femininity, toxic girl, how to scam a man, central. You already know that's me.
Right. Wait, everyone, please.
Okay, so on the.
Before you talk, I really want you to hear the audio though.
Okay, let me hear the audio. All
right, everyone, please mute up.
Bro, I got muted for literally doing the li-li-li-li-li-li-li-li-li when you told me you got married, and I finally saw you, and we just like I hopped on your live. They freaking banned me for that. I was like,
"Don't do it again! Don't do it again! Don't get banned!" Hey, I'm about to play the audio.
I mean, I gotta do it. I gotta do it for Africa. Okay, let me hear the audio.
Ladies, can we start a thread? Because I want to talk about something that I haven't heard. And I just want to know if anyone else, any women are experiencing this. Quick backstory. Coming up, I always had low self-esteem. I never felt attractive. I didn't really have friends. I was pretty much a loner. And so as an adult, I still have some of those thoughts in my mind. And it could honestly affect how I present myself when I'm out. But with that said, I have a lot of gorgeous friends, okay? Everybody's pretty. Everybody's pretty. Can we talk about how we are not the woman that's like ever approached in the friend group? More specifically, how you internalize it, how you deal with it. You know, because it's hard for me to believe that I'm the pretty girl when I'm out and men don't approach me. I tell you guys all the time that, like, I get the most attention from guys on the internet, not out in public. I for the most part, I've never approached, just to keep it a buck. Or I'm approached by super older guys, like 50 and up. Nobody in my age range. And I don't care how many times my friends tell me I'm pretty. People at church tell me I'm pretty. When it's all said and done and I'm in a room with them, I'm never seen.
Okay, so
and then you can't even really talk, ladies.
Noble, I'm gonna need you to pause, okay? Because I know exactly what's wrong with this girl.
Talk to me.
And you know me, I keep it above 100. I don't care. They come for me, they don't come for me, I don't care. I could always go back to Africa and they can't find me.
Thanks.
What is wrong with her is that she is not comfortable with who she is. First of all, right? On an internal level. Like, true. She does not feel good about who she is. She doesn't feel like she's pretty no matter what she does. And she feels like, okay, like, I'm not that girl that people walk up to. And let's be honest, her friends and the people she keeps around her, she doesn't actually see them as friends. She sees them as extensions of making her feel whole. And so no matter what they tell her, she will never feel good about herself. She's a hater.
What? How did you get all that from that audio?
Because I know her. I know that girl. We all know that girl. That girl is
a
hater.
So you actually know her?
Like in real life?
No, I don't have to know her in real life. I've known 1,000,001 copies of her. And we all know that kind of girl who is a hater, right? Who doesn't feel good about herself. And her friends have good intentions, right? And they want to make her feel good about herself, but she never sees it because she can never love herself, right? And so that is an internal issue. That girl has to find a psychiatrist.
I'm gonna take the story exactly as it sounds, and I'm gonna trust it to be just that. I'm not gonna hypothesize anything in my brain.
We gotta send and the girl to a psychiatrist. There's no other solution.
Okay, so I'm not gonna like I said, I'm not gonna hypothesize anything. I'm gonna take the story front face. So if I take a story front face, I could understand why. If people are telling her she's pretty, but she's out, she's wondering, because like the biggest thing of validation is when others validate you without you saying anything.
Okay, no.
You could have your self esteem all you want.
Okay, no, real quick, because I feel like you missed the crucial step, right? She not only said that she didn't feel good about herself, but her friends validated her, and then she proceeded to not feel good about herself. And then old men validated her. So all that told me was she has a big boom boom, and she still doesn't feel good about herself. And her friends were trying to help her. But continue.
So Vape, I think that what you said is true in some scenarios, but I'm not getting mm-hmm. that vibe from her. I don't think she's hating, because she didn't blame her friends for the reason why she wasn't being, you know, approach. She's not like, oh my gosh, like my friends, they're so this, like men always just approach them and forget about me. Like, that's not
but
the vibe she was
a
giving.
Hatred, though. No, but it like, is a hatred, though. Because let me ask you this, right?
Towards herself.
And as a woman, okay, but let me ask you this, like, as a woman to woman, right? Like, mm-hmm. if you're a girl who's like extremely insecure of herself, right? And you don't feel good about yourself, you go out with your friends get approached, of course you're going to take that as a slight, right?
Wait, say that again? You cut off of me.
Like, of course, like, if all your friends get approached but not you, you're going to mm-hmm. take that emotionally, deeply, right?
No.
So,
no,
so
you
said,
say
she
no,
said,
but that's not honest.
So, she said, no, she said, if you're already a woman that uh-huh. has low self-esteem, and you go out mm-hmm. with friends, and all your friends get approached by men, and
Got
you don't.
It. Got yeah, it. I thought she was asking me, like, personally. But no, what, yeah, that question, mm-hmm. yes. If you're already feeling low about yourself, of course, you're gonna, it's
yeah,
just further
and
what
so
you were feeling.
That's what it is. And then that turns into resentment, right? And let's be honest, you become a hater, because resentment turns you into a hater, and being a hater isn't anything
yeah.
negative.
Yeah.
Well, you know, the host mentioned something earlier.
Hold on, ladies. Hey, ladies. To the ladies, hold on. Ladies, please mute up. I want to give Genesis the floor, and then I want Issy to speak, because I do want to give women. I do want y'all to talk about this. And there's women that want to come up here, so I want to give the men 10 to 15 minutes to speak on this as they need fit, and then the floor will be y'all's. But go ahead, Genesis.
Okay, wait, real quick. I have to go. Sorry, Genesis. I have to go. I just want to say congratulations, Noble, on getting married. Shout out on the bad bidding.
Oh my God.
Remember to scam men.
Noble's not married.
I have Noble is married.
Thank you,
Noble
sis.
Is married.
Okay, let's see.
Noble
let's see the wife. Life. Let's see the
Listen,
wife.
My wife's sleeping.
We don't
right
care.
Now.
Okay, well, first of all, like, we're African. We never show you the wife.
Right, listen. I can't be putting my
no,
person.
No,
okay, but I gotta go.
We always show the wife.
All right, I'll talk to you later.
Okay, but I gotta go. Thank you. Thank you for having me, Noble. I just wanted to say hi. But I'll come back whenever you have a live and stuff.
This isn't your main account. Is this one of your burner accounts?
Bro, I have like a million and one burner accounts. You already know the rumor.
Right. Okay.
But inshallah, I'm gonna show up on your meeting. Like, I'm gonna see you live. I just want to say congratulations for your wedding without getting banned. Y'all, I gotta go check the ball game. All right,
I'll talk to you later with that.
Okay, right, bye. Thank you, guys. Everyone who's here, thank you so much for your input.
Go
May
ahead.
I
go
add
ahead.
Something
okay,
really quickly. This. I'm so sorry, Genesis. I just want to clear something up. I think that where Vape was going is that all that resentment can lead to hating, can lead to jealousy. And if she's not necessarily saying that she's jealous right now, because like I explained before, her wording
didn't show that she felt anything towards her actual friends. All she said about them was that they were gorgeous and that people approached them and not her. So it can lead to it, but let's not call her a hater or, you know, speak negatively about her. Yeah.
All right. Hey, Genesis, you got the floor, brother. The floor is yours. Go ahead.
Yeah, I was just going to say, it might depend on the type of friend she has also, because the brother spoke on something that's very valuable to understand. And we had a name for this, actually. We call it CB. CB. You ever hear of CB?
CB?
Yeah, CB.
No.
That's okay. So it's saying, you know, approaching girls in a group, you always have a couple friends that are like, oh, no, don't talk to my girl. She don't want nothing to do with you. Before right. you even get a chance. And so then we got the
cop blockers. Oh, okay. I know what you're talking about now. Okay. Oh.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay,
so
yeah. You're talking about a C blocker.
Yeah, yeah. We don't even know what type of her friend group. So while we're listening to this, we're making we can all make assumptions, but we don't. She hasn't spoke about the friend group, how they move, their code on when guys approach. So there's so many reasons that we don't even understand. So like for me, I'm listening to it. And I understand why she would be like, oh, well, she wants validation. Because, like, I used to live a different type of life, which was more of an illegal life. And when I came around, since I was down a bus ahead, they're like, yo, that's the Knicks. And so all the other Knicks that weren't down the bus ahead, they're like, that's the Knicks. Because I'll slide through and handle business. Because so I can understand why she's like, well, I don't feel validated. Because ain't nobody coming up to me. See me, I never had to toot my horn to be like, yo, I'm the Knicks. Because other people said I'm the Knicks. She's like, why aren't other people saying I'm pretty? And I don't know if she has lost focus. But like I said, it's so much more than just her saying what she's saying. Because she would have to be so specific and here. So everything else is just assumptions. And so I understand why she's feeling like that. I totally understand. And like I said, it's crazy because I've seen it too many times that every freaking girl group has that CB. Where it's like, oh, girl, don't talk to him. Walk away. You see this? Someone steps in your face. It's like, oh, we're busy right now. Or right. It's like, oh, girl, we got to go. Let's go this way.
Right.
So it's crazy. So what's really going on? What is really going on? And that's what I'm saying. Because I don't even know what's going on. I can hear the audio. But I can only make assumptions from the audio. Because I don't get to see the background.
But she also, and you're talking about her friend group right now, but she also says that, like, even when she is by herself, she said if she does get hit on, it's the rare times that she does get approached. She says she gets approached by men that are like age 50 and older, and she says that she gets attention from men online, but she didn't say anything about her even attempting to try to like approach men or reach out to men either. So we talk about her friends, but even when she's by herself, she's still not getting that attention that she's seeking.
Okay, so on that part, I would just say, like, if she is that pretty, some guys are intimidated because they're like, this girl will say no. Like, live-wise, like, yo, she'll say no. So I don't want to approach. Some guys are scared to take that L, that 50-50% chance where it's like, let me go holler at this pretty lady, see what she's saying. And just to say, hey, what's up? To say, oh, well, she's just going to reject me. Because, like, if you watch how it works, man, I'll be sitting in a group of guys and be like, oh, homeboy's like, I'm going to get that number. And we're like, nah, man, you go get that number, man. Because we just clown and play, man. But we ain't trying to hurt no homeboy's feelings. He's like, nah, I'm going to get that. It's like, yo, go ahead. Homeboy goes to shoot a shot, but we're sitting across the little freaking bar here. And then he don't get it because she shot him down. We're like, oh, but you know the face the whole group makes? Like, right. Oh, my God, damn. Nigga, you got shot down because a lot of guys are intimidated. They're intimidated by beauty. Like, this girl may be a bitch low-key because she knows she's pretty and, like, really, who am I? So there's so many factors. So I don't know. Like I said, if I'd have to know the person, and all other than that, I'm just speculating.
Yeah, and I'm going to get to you, Susan, but she also, you know, it's one thing to, like, not be attracting the type of man or the type of men that you want in your life. But it's another thing, Genesis, to not even be getting approached at all. Like, imagine it's one, you don't get approached when you go out in social settings with your friends, and you don't get approached when, I don't know, you at Starbucks or you grocery shopping, you at the gas station, you at the bank. You don't get approached, you know, in any of those places either. And mind you, this is a woman that says that she's been having self-esteem issues since she was a child. So, like you said in the video, she has people that tell her that she's beautiful. She has people that tell her that she's pretty. But every time when she's outside and you looking at your friends that you deem to be pretty and they're getting attention from men, but you're not getting any attention from men, I mean, I could kind of understand why you might in your head be like, how pretty am I for real? And that's why I'm asking, who really determines your value in the dating market? Do you determine it? Do your friends determine it? Or do the people that are going to be pursuing you determine it? Because Genesis, you could think you're the most handsome man in the world. You can look in the mirror, feel confident, this, that, and the third, but no girl wants to talk to you. So realistically, just being real, you probably gonna think about how handsome you are. You're gonna try to do some sort of deep diving as to why you're not attracting women.
Well, you know, I see what you're saying. The key point though is she said it's mostly older guys, and older guys, we actually really don't biz. We'll slide up because like we've already conceptualized all these things we're talking about. So it doesn't really matter to us because we've already got our shit together where we get, yo, what's up? We can actually roll up and feel, yo, she says yes, she says yes, she says no, she says no. So it's not like she's not getting approached. This is the market that she's, let's say, that she desire. It's not hitting her up.
Hey, Issy, did you want to say something before I move to Susan? Issy, did you want to say something?
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
I kind of felt me as like a I used to be like insecure, right? Mm-hmm. So and I get in the sense of like the being the ugly duckling in the friend group, but then and like as men, typically as men, they'll be like, hey, get your game up then. Hey, we gonna go to the gym and we gonna get you to feel like, hey, you that guy. We gonna put you up on that. So I was able to they were able to push me into the center, into the place that I felt like, hey, now I'm that guy. Oh, now when we go out as a group, now oh, it's not just them. You know, they were they were helpful in pushing me and throwing lobs, you know. Let me introduce you to this and everything like that. So I was able to, what is it called? Latch onto their help for that. So I get in the sense of what she's saying because of being that type of person. Me personally though, and I know Z has said like don't go like for other friends like that are like not that you feel like you're prettier than. I mean, I used to have a height thing, and I mean, I was just hang around like dudes that shorter than you. You look taller. I mean, I can admit that, like, and I don't think that's bad necessarily.
Well, I do think that's bad if your sole intention of being around someone is solely to make yourself feel better and make yourself feel more confident, man or woman. I do think that's a bad thing. But what the difference is that, like, because this is just how men are. And I'm sure this woman, I'm sure her making this video, I'm sure the woman that she calls her friends, I would think and hope that she's expressed these things to them before. But when she has expressed these things to her friends, have her friends told her, like, hey girl, you know, you're very much overweight and we need to like hit the gym. You know, we might need to do some counseling. We might need to do some therapy. We might need to actually work on getting your self-esteem up and your self-confidence up. Or are you just telling her that you are beautiful and you are pretty and it's just the men? You don't have anything to do with it. You don't have any accountability in the results that you're getting in real life. Despite the fact that all of us have accountability in the results that we get in real life. So what are your friends telling you? You get what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Do you have any last things you want to say before I move on to Susan?
No, you can go on, Susan.